take all my sin. Red kid and poor, lost, lonely within. But in wondrous compassion, the King of all kings, in pity and love, He took me under His wings. Oh yeah, oh yeah, I'm a child of the King. His royal blood now flows through my veins, and I, who was wretched and poor, now can say, praise God, praise God, I'm a child of the King. Now I am a child of His heavenly home. For my holy Father, He's made me His own. I've been bought by His blood, and I've been clothed with His love. And today I'll sing with the angels above. Oh yeah, oh yeah, I'm a child of the King. His royal blood now flows through my veins, and I, who was wretched and poor, now can sing, praise God, I'm a child of the King. They tell me that one time there was an old man walking along the highway, tired, worried, and hungry. As he traveled on his way, he come to a rich farmer's home, and he stopped and knocked at the door. The farmer answered the call, and as he looked down upon the old man looked up and smiled and said, "Sir," said, "I'm tired, worried, and I'm hungry. I'd love to have a place to sleep and some food to eat. And mister, I don't want you to think that I'm begging you for it. If you have some work that I can do, I'll work for it." The farmer looked down on him and compassion struck his heart. As he looked on the old man, he said, "Mister, I've got a ditch to be dug going from my barn into the meadow. If you'll dig that ditch, I'll give you food to eat and a place to sleep, clothes to wear, and money to travel on when you get ready to travel on your way." The old man looked up through a smile and said, "Thank you, sir," and he took the job. A few days later, while he was down the ditch with his pick and shovel, my the little boy wandered down that way, and he heard the old man as he was saying something. He wandered over closer to the ditch, and he listened to it. And as he listened, he heard the old man saying something like this: oh yes, I'm a child of the King. His royal blood now flows through my veins, and I, who was wretched and poor, now can sing, praise God, I'm a child of the King." The little boy said, "Mister," said, "I can't understand how you can be a child of the King and be so poor. You don't look like no child of the King to me. Most children of kings, why, they have a good bed to sleep in, and they have clothes to wear that's beautiful." And said, "You look like a bum to me, sir. Why, your beard's grown out, your hair's long, and your clothes is torn and worn. And I can't understand how you can be a child of the King." And about that time, the old man raised up from the ditch, the tears running down in his cheeks. And he looked over at the little boy, and he said, "Son," he said, "I'm a child of a real King. My father's rich, and he owns everything. Said, son, can you look down yonder in the valley? Do you see them lilies growing down there? My father made those lilies, and he likened himself unto them. Look out yonder at that pretty lake on your daddy's farm. You see all that water? My father owns that water and holds all the water in the palms of his hand. And son, look at those pretty cattle grazing yonder on your father's pasture. Them belongs to my father. He's rich, son, and he holds those in the palms of his hand. And he owns all the cattle of 1,000 hills. Son, my father's rich. And as he talked to him, he said, I want you to listen. You hear the little birds singing? And the boy listened. He said, my father made them, son. And he feeds all of them and knows where they fall. Son, do you see that big sun ball hanging out yonder? My father made that and hung it out on nothing. And they tell me about that time the little boy broke and he run for home. He runs up to his daddy and he said, Dad, said you don't need that old man down yonder. He just got through telling me he was a child of the king. Said his father said he was rich and he owned everything. His father, he said, owned your cattle and the cattle of 1,000 hills. Held all the water that was in your lake and all the waters in the palms of his hand. And Daddy, he said his father, he made the little star of those where they fall. And Tuck made the lily of the valley and knocking himself onto it. Made the big sun ball and hung it out on nothing. Said, I can't understand it, Daddy. How you can be so poor and yet so rich. And about that time, the farmer reached out and pulled his little boy up to him. He said, son, the old man knows what he's talking about. His father is the king of kings, and he's rich. He owns everything. Everything that me and mommy have belongs to him. The little boy dropped his head, and as it did, I began to think about a hillbilly boy one day with a washboard mommy and a coal-mining daddy that had raised him up. He had wandered out yonder in the ruts of sin. But one day the King of Kings come by, and he reached down and took a hold of my hand and pulled me out of the miry clays of sin and set my feet on a solid rock and established my goings in him. And ever since that day, I've been a child of the King. I know today that he's the King of Kings because he saved my soul. And you that's listening to me right now, if you don't have Jesus in your heart, he'd love to save you. He'd love for you to be his child. And he'd love to be your king. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. I'm happy today because I know that I'm a child of the king. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. I'm a child of the king. His royal blood now flows through my veins, and I, who was wretched and poor, now can sing. Praise God, I'm a child of God.